So I think Easter Sunday, and you'll have packed churches all over our country. I think it would be a beautiful time. And it's just about the timeline that I think is right. It gives us more chance to work on what we're doing. And I'm not sure that's going to be the day, but I would love to aim it right at Easter Sunday. So we're open for church service and services generally on Easter Sunday. That would be a beautiful thing.
I just thought it was a beautiful time. It would be a beautiful time, a beautiful timeline.
So that was based on the data?
It was based on a certain level of weeks from the time we started. And it happened to arrive. Actually, we were thinking in terms of sooner. I'd love to see it come even sooner. But I just think it would be a beautiful timeline.
Donald Trump does not believe that life is worth living if you lose money. If you have less money this year than last year, if you have a lot less money this year than last year, then the obvious choice is to kill yourself, because life is not worth living in Donald Trump's value system.
Things are bad because of the virus, which is devilish. They're also bad because the president refused to act early on and because he is still holding back now. And if he continues to swing wildly back and forth and contradict himself and try to sell America on his own response the way you try to get someone to close on a crappy condo, well, then even more Americans are going to suffer.
The question becomes, what is the basis for his optimism other than belief in the Easter Bunny?
Mr. President, please recognize that storm is coming and stop telling people they're going to go out on their sailboats on Easter Day with a Category 5 hurricane roaring on shore.
The president's worried about the economy. He's worried about his reelection. Obviously, those two things are related. But if you listen carefully to that briefing last night, I think you heard the president backing off from that ardent desire to reopen the country, as he's stated, by Easter.
I think that the president, as he has been doing, is very hopeful and wants to have a message of hope to the American people. I think he would love it if we were opened up for business yesterday. But after the 15 days, when we see the data come in, we'll see where we're at. And I think the president will make his decision now. But he is hopeful.
We don't control Mother Nature. She controls us. We can do everything we can to react to it, but we have to do it based on the science and what the doctors tell us. Listen, Easter is a blessed day for so many people in the world, but it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to gather people in God's name if, in fact, that's going to hurt us more.
I think that it's pretty clear that the numbers are increasing, and the pace at which they're increasing is also going up. So, you know, it's kind of like a issue where you not only have the numbers of people who are infected, but the inertia around this outbreak in the United States is also increasing, which is why I think the World Health Organization is concerned this could become the next epicenter.
What we were talking about in terms of Easter, we really don't know when we're going to get this under control. It's extraordinarily important that we harmonize whatever restrictions we have across the country, because we have porous borders between states, between cities, and unless we're consistent, we're not going to get ahead of this thing.
But to give a target date right now, especially so soon after things are still rising, I believe is premature, and I would advise the president, let's hold off on this at least a bit.